What a cold, but such a beautiful and strong. Skyrim deserves to survive this terrific dragon menace. Jotter don't like to be a hero, but to save this beautiful place, he will try. Prepare yourself, Alduin. This one would not even remember that all who can read these strange scrolls are blind. There is no way back. What a strange magic. What is this? Is this a past?
But I honor your courage, Kreefwolf Akrin. Die now in vain.
Another Elder Scroll? Interesting. Rest in peace, brave warrior.
Take your time.
Oh, so what is it, Rus, like? Alduin was not killed. Nord Hero were not able to defeat him, and they banished him. But this damned lizard seems to devour souls in Soundgarde somehow, and turn back with the full power. Here you are, Ward Eater. But this one is prepared. Jotar will not banish you. Prepare to die.
Thank you.
Land, you dragon. Land and face Jotar. Do you feel it? Do you feel it, monster? Ah.
You are too late.
arrogant. You not say this. May the fate smiles on Khajiit. You will fall now. Elsewhere is home for this one. You will not ruin it after Skyrim. And you will not ruin the Skyrim too, you damn monster. Tremble, Alduin, the first and last time in your life. You will fall now. Is this the end? This one helps. Now, turn back, you coward! This is unacceptable. This one must finish Alduin. Once and forever.
Lot Congrach, you truly have the voice of a Dovah. Alduin's allies will think twice after this victory. Nilivrach hin moro. True, this is not the final Krongrah victory, but not even the heroes of old were able to defeat Alduin in open battle. Alduin always was Pachlok, arrogant in his power. This should
come on, old man. Jotar likes to talk with you, but now. Yes. We just don't have a time
one
for this. Please help this one faster, and this one will finish everything.
But it will not be so easy to convince one of them to betray him. Perhaps the Hafkasayun, the palace in Whiterun, Dragon's Reach. It was originally built to house a captive Dovah. A fine place to trap one of Alduin's allies, yes, but your Sum is strong. I do not doubt that you... Yes, this was ages ago, you understand. There were more of us then. Before the Bruniki, the Akaviri came and killed all my... I used to visit him from time to time, nearly crazed by loneliness and captivity. I do not know how he came to be caught, but the Bronyun, the Jarl, was very proud of his pet, Pak. The Hafkasayun has been known as Dragon's Reach ever since. Look, Thum.
So, just another crazy idea. This one only interesting how the Jarl will react to this. This one got injured in this fierce battle. This is an important task, but Chotar needs to rest a bit first.
Fear not, from dragon or giant.
Hey, what?
I work with my mother, sell fruits and vegetables. It's fun, but...
Oh, Lydia. This one is glad to see you too. Just a short recover, and in battle once again.
Up for a little hunting?
Thank you.
yes?
Terrible and powerful Talos. We are unworthy servants.
It's good to see you again.
No spies, saboteurs, and assassins to send against us.
Excellent. You've done us a great service. Here is your reward. I must have misheard you. I thought you asked me to help you trap a dragon in my
house. No, old man. You heard everything correctly, unfortunately.
I don't understand. Why let a dragon into the heart of my city? Alduin, the World Eater himself. But how can we fight him? Doesn't his return mean it's the end times? I didn't say anything about... Now what's this nonsense about trapping a dragon in my palace? I want to help you, Dragonborn. And I will. Ulfric and General Tullius are both just waiting for me to make a wrong move. Do you think they will sit idle while the dragon is slaughtering my men and burning? No. I can't risk weakening the city while we are under the threat of enemy attack. I'm sorry. Then I would be... But getting both sides to agree to a truce will be difficult at... Maybe. What of the Grey... If the Greybeards were willing to host a peace council, then maybe Ulfric and... I, Dragonborn, maybe you can stop the dragons and this war into the bargain. According to legend, Numenex was the dragon's name.
Talks, and more talks again and again. We don't have much time to talk. We need to save the Skyrim.
Alduin? We heard the DRAGONREND shout from here. You defeated...
I feared as much. I thought it was him we saw flying east after...
We are not warriors. What is overlooked in the Dragonborn is not permitted to any other followers of the Way of the Void.
You misunderstand our authority. The Greybeards have never involved themselves in political affairs.
You're afraid of politics?
Dragon will
old man. The fate of Skyrim is in your hands now.
Made the decision to help you. This is the road we have. Even the Greybeards must bend to the winds of change, it seems. So be it. We will see if they still remember us. The old tales say that he can travel. You must find out how he does this before he regains his strength and returns.
A really strange source for Khajiit, but this one thinks that one day he may like this snow.
Give us a straight answer.
He's a true Nord. He'll come around.
Don't be so smart, man. We've intercepted couriers from Solitude. The Empire's putting a great deal of pressure on
yes.
my one.
Yes, make it quick. It's about time they turned their gaze from the heavens back to our bleeding homeland. What do they want? I have the greatest respect for the Greybeards, of course. But the political situation is still delicate. Not all the... I can't afford to appear weak. I can't agree to this unless...
Ah, you stubborn little boy. Come on.
Alduin, the world eater of song and legend. Even Tullius may be forced to talk sense in the face of such a threat. Yes, I'll give Tullius one more chance to quit Skyrim. And what would you have me do?
If he's not with us, he's against us.
He knows that. They all know that.
How long are you going to wait?
Dragonborn, it is my honor to stand before you.
Solitude is so beautiful at evening.
I'm a little busy.
A perfect place for a night walk for Khajiit. In peaceful times, of course.
Let me...
Tell me again why I'm wasting men chasing after a fairy tale.
So, will this one be an another stubborn boy?
It'll be a problem.
We need the rift. The Greybeards. What do those old hermits want with... Why, there's nothing to discuss as long as that traitor... They are getting to be a problem. But I wasn't sent to... My job is to quell this rebellion, and I intend to do just that.
And why this one is not surprised,
It's getting difficult to even... By all accounts, the Stormcloaks are suffering just as badly. Even... Yes, fine. I'll come to this Greybeard Council.
Don't you Nords put any stock in your own tradition? I thought the Moot chose the king. We're back.
Oh, hello, my fluffy friend.
Done it. Men of violence are gathered here. I should not have agreed to host this council. The Greybeards have no business involving ourselves in such matters. Peace? I doubt it. They may put their weapons down for a moment, but only to gather strength. They are not yet tired of war. Far from it. Do you know the ancient Nord word for war? but regrets are pointless. Take your seat at the council table, and let us see what wisdom we can find among these warriors of Skyrim.
So, our gear, is it? You know why we're here. Are you going to let us in or not?
You're not invited here. You're not welcome here.
Ah, at last. A chair at political council. The last chair Khajiit would like to sit in. Ah.
Now that everyone is here, please take your seats so we can begin. I hope that we have all come here in the spirit
of... No, you insult us by bringing her to this negotiation. Your chief talus hunter?
That didn't take long.
Diplomatic. Hear, hear.
I have every right to be at this negotiation. I need to ensure that nothing is agreed to here that violates the terms of the White Gold Concordat.
She's part of the Imperial delegation. You can't dictate who I bring to this council.
Please, if we have to negotiate the terms of the negotiation, we will never get anywhere. Perhaps this would be a good time to get the Dragonborn's input on this matter.
What do you think? Are we going to let Ulfric dictate terms to us before the negotiations even start? I'm glad we see.
And this one glad that this one is does not care at all.
No, we'll stay. Out of respect for the Dragonborn and our graybeard hosts. But she is to observe, nothing more. We are not negotiating with her. Is that clear?
Ulfric, why so hostile? After all, it's not the Thalmor that's burning your farms and killing your sons.
She's supposed to be on our side?
No, exactly. No. Not this time.
Now that that's settled, may we proceed?
I have something to say first.
Here we go.
The only reason I agreed to attend this council was to deal with the dragon menace. There's nothing else to talk about. Unless the Empire is finally ready to renounce its unjust claim to rule over the free people of Skyrim.
I knew he wouldn't be able to resist.
Temporary truce to allow the Dragonborn here to deal with the dragons, nothing more. I consider even talking to the Empire a generous gesture.
Are you done? Did you just come here to make speeches, or can we get down to business?
Yes, let's get this over with.
Are we ready to proceed? Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, this council is unprecedented. We are gathered here at the Dragonborn's request. I ask that you all respect the spirit of High Hrothgar and do your best to begin the process of achieving a lasting peace in Skyrim. Who would like to open the negotiations?
Yes, let's get down to it. We want control of Markarth. That's our price for agreeing to a truce.
So that's why you're here, Ulfric? You dare to insult the Greybeards by using this council to advance your own position?
Jarl Elisif!
General, this is outrageous. You can't be taking this demand seriously. I thought we were here to discuss a truce.
Elisif, I said I'd handle it. Ulfric, you can't seriously expect us to give up Markarth at the negotiating table. You hope to gain in council what you've been unable to take in battle, is that it?
I'm sure Jarl Ulfric does not expect something for nothing.
Yes, that'd be entirely out of character.
Want in return?
Wait, General, you don't intend to just hand over Markarth to that traitor.
This is how the Empire repays us for our loyalty?
Enough. First, let's be clear. This council wasn't my idea. I think it's a waste of time. You are a traitor to the Empire and deserve a traitor's death. But I at least will negotiate in good faith. Since we're all here at your request, I'd like to hear what you think Markarth is worth. In exchange for Markarth, the source of most of Skyrim's silver.
Hardly.
Riften seems like a better choice to me. Well fortified, easily resupplied from across Lake Honrik. Plus all the mead we can drink. Not enough to outweigh the loss of Markarth. With the Reach in enemy hands, our whole position in Solitude would be threatened. I'm glad you agree. I was starting to wonder whose side you were on here. You heard the man, Ulfric. We've made you...
After Skyrim Civil War, this one knows. War is not a war. War, it is a simple trading.
I came here in good faith, despite your known Imperial sympathy. As for you, General Tullius, I see now that Garmar was right. Talking to the Empire is just as useless as ever. If you think you can hold Markarth, you're as deluded as your Emperor when he signed away our freedom to the Thalmor. Skyrim will never again bow to your false Empire. Let's go, Garmar. I should have listened to you in the first place.
You always were a fool, Ulfric. You're no better at diplomacy than you are in the battlefield.
Oh, are you so blind to our danger that you can't see past your petty disagreement? Here you sit arguing about nothing, while the fate of the land hangs in the balance.
Is he with you, Delphi? If so, I advise you to tell him to watch his tongue.
He is with me, and I advise you both to listen to what he has to say before you do anything rash.
Don't you understand the danger? Don't you understand what the return of the dragons means? Alduin has returned, the World Eater. Even now he devours the souls of your fallen comrades. He grows more powerful with every soldier slain in your pointless war. Can you not put aside your hatred for even one moment in the face of this mortal danger?
A very pretty speech. But what does it have to do with
that? If he's right about Alduin. We both have just as much to lose here, Tullius. Remember that. Now, back to the matter at hand. Don't hand me a mug of sheep's piss and call it mead. These terms are still not acceptable.
I'm sure you have something in mind.
Damn right we do.
You surrender Hjalmarch to us, and take Idgrod Ravencrone with you. Sorli the Builder will take over as Jarl of Morthal.
Where do these demands stop, Ulfric? Do you expect me to surrender all of Skyrim?
It seems I have no choice but to let the Dragonborn decide. Although I'm starting to doubt your fairness. What say you, Dragonborn?
Why are you asking, Jotar? This one is just an accidental traveler that happened to travel with you to Helgen. Do you remember this?
You treat us fairly. Thank you. I suppose that's the fairest deal we're likely to get.
It seems we may have an agreement. Jarl Ulfric, General Tullius, these are the terms currently on the table. Markarth will be handed over to Ulfric's forces, Jarl Idmund will step down, and Thangvor Silverblood will become the Jarl of Markarth. Stormcloaks will withdraw from the rift, allowing Imperial troops unhindered access. Jarl Leila Lawgiver will step down, and Maven Blackbriar will become the Jarl of Riften. Jarl March will be turned over to Ulfric, with Sorli the Builder assuming the Jarlship. You both agree to this?
The Sons of Skyrim will live up to their agreements. As long as the Imperials, support for theirs. What about you, Alyssa? Are these terms to your liking? Speak up! I'm sure General Tullius is waiting to do your bidding.
I have nothing to say to that murderer. General, you've proven yourself a good friend to Skyrim. I continue to trust that you will do your utmost to safeguard our interests.
Thank you, Jarl Ellison. I appreciate your loyalty. The Empire can live with these terms, yes, for a temporary truce, until the dragon menace is dealt with. After that, Ulfric, there will be a reckoning. Count on it. Taking control of the Rift was a great victory. Ulfric must be rather nervous with us so close to his doorstep.
Come on, Domar. We have a lot of work to do.
Giving up Markarth is a heavy price for this.
Blah, 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 blah. Go away, you. This one can't believe we finished these talks.
Yes, I'm ready to do my part. Just say the word, and my men will help you spring this trap.
But the difficulty remains, how to lure a dragon to Dragon's Reach at all?
Well, that's an excellent question. You haven't overlooked that little deep. He'll have you.
Ah, I believe I can be of help here. I anticipated the problem. An unguessed cross-reference in this with... don't you see? The names of dragons are all... By calling the dragon with a voice, he will hear. He's not compelled to, but dragons are prideful. I think it's very likely. Ah, indeed. Odavin, winged snow hunter, as I read it.
There's one more thing. We know about Parthenax. That's fine. We needed his help. Now we don't. And it's long past time, and he's not just any dragon. He was the right hand of Alduin. He committed atrocities so in... He needs to die. Until he's dead.
To kill the Parthenax? Are you mad, Delphine? You obviously are.
If they had their way, the Greybeard... Think about it. No. Trust me. There is no need to be afraid. Think of Tiber Septim. Do you think he'd have founded the Empire if he'd listened to the Greybeards?
Rested and well fed. At least something is good today. So much happened. And this one need to have a good rest before the next strike. See you soon, my friends.